Hello, I'm Luke Duffercy and welcome to this edition of YOG TV.
And I'm Emily Ridlington. We're here at the top of the north chain of Seegruber looking over Innsbruck.
But today, down in the city, Arnel Dalmado and Ben Friedman were checking out the curling.
Right now, we are in Innsbruck's exhibition hall. What do you have to say about curling?
We are watching curling and it's a really interesting game. That's the truth.
Yeah, but where's the ball?
That's the other thing I just wanted to say. We have no ball. We have no snow. I don't know.
Why are they wiping the floor like this?
It's something strange. I think we need a ball also.
We need a ball. We need to invent a new game, you know? Because this game is nice, but we have to improve it a little bit.
Maybe we can become famous after this.
Yeah, you think so?
I think.
Let's give it a try.
Okay, let's do it.
Wouldn't it be nice?
Practice on sweeping in the home, like you're cleaning the floor and stuff like this?
No, just in the curling hall.
We have a question. We saw that you like to scream all the time, like to motivate your friend. Do you think it helps you?
Yeah, I think it helps a lot.
Yeah. How do you choose when to scream and when to be quiet?
I watch the stones and the movement, and when they are like slowly sweeping, then I scream, yes.
Do you think you can scare off the other teammates when you scream like that, or your rivals?
No, I think it helps.
Only to motivate?
Yeah.
But if you like scream harder, maybe you can scare the others.
No, I don't think so.
you just play with the other Adviento, I think it is, the one from New Zealand. She screams a lot.
Oh yeah, she's a real nice girl. She has this awesome voice, like, nice shot. She's real positive, it's always fun to play with her.
Especially in Norway, we have some players that are screaming really, really loud. And just now we changed, so we had a new ice skip. She's almost not skipped before, so she's really a little bit nervous, so yeah.
If a ball could improve this game a little bit, to add a ball in the game.
Like a ball in football?
Yeah.
I don't know. How would you do that?
We're just thinking about it.
Like baseball. Yeah. Sand a stone, take the baseball bat up and shoot.
Oh, that could be great.
And yes, I love shouting. It's a way to get my energy out. Yeah. You know?
Do you think it's more like motivating your team or you're like more scaring your rivals? Oh.
Both, definitely both. It definitely motivates my team for sure. I've always asked them, do you want me to shout at you or does it put you off? They're like, yes, shout at us, please. So yeah.
And what do you shout? Well, what is your catchphrase when you shout?
Sweep hard and stuff like that. Just
sweep hard?
Yeah, just like particular words. You don't want to talk like a sentence, you know, when you're shouting.
And your voice is okay after the game?
Yeah. It's better. It's even better, actually.
Can you make not like a big scream, but a little scream, like what you do?
Scream.
Yeah.
Hard!
All right. Nice work at the curling, boys. But Emily, they're also up to some other things today.
I also heard that, but I know that they had some difficulties communicating in the local language.
Hello, this is Ben. I'm Arnel. We are part of the Young Reporters program. This is the Young Reporters show. And now we are going to do what, Ben?
It's a good question, Anne. God, I'm trying to think what we are going to do. The thing is, we're going to ask some people on the street, like, what do they think about Innsbruck 2012, if they like the Olympic Games, if they're going to the events.
I think it's a good idea. Let's
do it. Yeah, we thought about it together.
Okay.
You're so smart.
Can I make you some question?
Okay.
Thank you a lot.
Hello, can I ask you one question?
Oh, danke.
Oh, danke.
Hi, can I ask you some questions? Okay, thank you.
Hello, can I ask you one question, please? Why not? Danke. Excuse me, one question?
These two.
Excuse me, can we ask you one question? Oh, I know. What's
something
going on?
Is happening.
Something is not working.
Okay.
What do you have to do? It's like, we dress good. We don't look Austrian.
Look at that.
Oh my God.
Look at that.
It's an Austrian clothing store.
We need that. Let's go inside.
We need that.
I would like to know what kind of clothes is this? What's their name?
The Austrian national costume.
Uh-huh.
And they maybe this one is lederhose for the men. And you have to the Tindal Kleid. Over there.
Yeah.
And just like a boy, they use for everything, weddings and birthday party or another ceremony.
And you can also find people wearing this kind of clothes on the street, walking on the street, you can find them?
Yes,
yeah?
you can find them.
But most of it in summer?
In summer, also, well, in winter too. Okay.
Do you think that if we dress like that, people on the street would answer more questions and would be nicer with us?
Maybe, why not?
Anel, where are you? Oh, look at us.
You're nice.
You're nice too.
Oh, thank you.
You're nice, right? Thank you.
I believe you.
We need something more traditional.
To help us some time.
Yeah, okay. Okay, let's go. Tiro, tiro. Where are you? What? Oh, I mean, you're a lady. How's your lady, Anel?
I don't have heroes inside here.
Give me your hand.
I like it anyway.
Tino Peter. How are you, Karen?
Fine, thank you.
I have one question, because I know you don't want to talk much. When do you use this traditional clothing? When exactly?
I use it to work, only off to Jungbauernball for Filmung.
I do with my head like this, like I understand everything.
He's freezing.
Oh, well, that's enough from those two boys. Now it's time to have a look at today's triple shot.
So if you weren't a snowboarder, what sport would you like to participate in?
I think like skeleton or luge or something.
If you could go to any country in the world to travel, what would it be?
New Zealand.
What have been your favorite moments from the game so far?
I think just the competition 2 days ago, it was pretty good, and yeah, I'm enjoying it, so.
Skiing or snowboarding down the slopes can be a lot of fun, but boarders and skiers do have to take some precautions.
That's right, Emily. The mountains can pose a lot of dangers, though back where I live in Australia, I'm probably more likely to get attacked by a killer wombat than stuck in an avalanche. So I thought it would be best if you took the snow awareness training.
I understand you wouldn't be using those skills. I've done polar bear safety, gun safety, so why not avalanches? Help, I need somebody. Help, not just anybody. Help, you know I need someone.
Help, when I was young, so much younger than today. So Stefan, today you taught some Finnish athletes mountain safety training. Why is it so important, especially to teach young people safety before they go out on the slopes?
Well, young people, sometimes they are not aware that there are dangers out outside the pistes in the off-piste area. And so, but still they want to enjoy the powder, the untracked slopes. And therefore, it's very important to give them the information, okay, if you go into the backcountry, you need the rescue gear, which is a transceiver, a shovel, and a probe.
And most athletes who are here have never seen mountains like these. What's so special about this region?
The region in the Tyrol offers a lot of different resorts which offer fantastic off-piste skiing. And not only on-piste skiing, but also off-piste skiing. And so this is really the variety here in the Tyrol is really maybe next to none. Yeah.
And the athletes have quite the busy schedules, but if they do get a chance to hit the slopes, what's the best advice you can give them?
The best advice is to enjoy the nature. We want our students and the young people to go out into the nature, but to use their brain and to be careful.
Now, in the Arctic where I live, I've been in igloos, but I've never been in an avalanche. And I really hope the Finnish boys who are doing search and rescue are going to come find me soon, because it's cold and Luke can't host the show by himself. That's bad news. Thomas, what did you think about that avalanche safety course?
I think it was good because we don't know so much about the backcountry because we are living in Finland and there is not much big mountains and powder.
And do you feel confident now that you know what to do if you were out there on the hills that you could help someone?
Yeah, very confident.
Okay, and I guess you use this probe, so what do you do with this?
I put it in the snow where the victim is and do like pushing it through the snow so I can feel where he is or she and yeah, and see how deep he is. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down and I do appreciate you being around.
Well, it's nice to see you back and that you made it out okay and that you are able to continue to host the show with me.
Props to the Finnish snowboarders, otherwise I might be still stuck under the snow. In any case, I understand that you met a very special group of people at the CEP today.
That's right, there's cultural education booths of each country participating in the games, and I met two special schools who've formed a special relationship over the last few months. Here at the Cultural Education Program, each country that's participating in the Games will be featured in a booth. The booths are run by local children and change every couple of days. Well, we're here at the Latvian booth, and first of all, can you tell me what you're doing here?
Our teacher said to us we should go there, and it's a really interesting language, for example, and there are lots of things we can present. We present music, history, or anything.
We're actually witnessing something really special here today. The school which is running the CEP booth of Poland actually has a sister class in Poland, and the two groups of students are meeting for the first time right now. We're actually here with the teachers of the two classes, and first of all, can you explain to us how this program started?
So we took part in a sports event, and students came up to us and asked us if we wanted to get involved, if I wanted to present a country, and I was very happy to do that with my class, and then I got information on it, and they linked us with the partner school, and I got in touch with Anna, our partner teacher, and so it worked out.
Fantastic. What do you think the children will get out of this?
Well, they will learn different cultures, and that's very important. They will learn that the whole world is open to them and they can get everything they want, and that they can speak English, which is very important to them, and they now enjoy it very much. And just friendship, they will get lots of friends, they will meet lots of people here, and that's very important also.
Excellent. Sounds like a fantastic program. So thanks a lot for showing it to us, and I hope all the children have a great time.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, it was a great story and great to be there for the first meeting of the two schools.
Indeed. Now, I don't know about you, but I've had an excellent day here out at Seegruber, but that's all the time we have for now. Thanks for watching.
We'll see you next time.